Yeah, this is a road that was just done recently. You can see the situation. This is the Chepseon Mailine Kipkelion Road. There's also a link road to a place called Brook Bond. And you can see the situation of the road. Very poor state. I am at Chepseon. This is the Chepseon Kipkelion Road. Done very recently, 1.6 billion Kenya shillings. And you can see the situation. Unaona barabara? Hii ni barabara imejengwa juzi, 1.6 billion Kenya shillings. And you can see the situation. Ona sasa. Very poor state. Very poorly done. Very bad condition. So that you believe me, confirm. Niko new KCC, Chepseon. This is Kericho County. So this is my message to the people of Rift Valley. Tribalism is a lie, sold by politicians at a cheap price. Don't believe it. Because if tribalism is real, then the people from your tribe should be doing development. But you can see, hii barabara ilijengwa very bad quality. You can see the condition of the road. Sasa mnaweza sema hii ni barabara ya juzi hii. Is this worth 1.6 billion? If you think of it properly, hii barabara, unaweza sema hii ni barabara ya juzi kweli. Ilianza wakati ya Uhuru na Ruto. This one. I mean, how long is a road supposed to last? Kama hii ni barabara ya juzi inakaa namna hii. And it's like that, all of it. Nasikia hata watu wanashout kutoka ndani ya magari Morara, hiyo barabara ni mbaya. It's bad. It's a terrible road. Whoever did this, they should be arrested. No, we are not just talking about roads that were never done. We are also talking about roads that were done and done poorly with theft of public funds to a very large extent. You can see this road is like this all the way from Chepseon, to Mailine, to Kipkelion, to a place that I'm told called Jambo Kenya, to Brook Bond. Wanamnaibia wa Kenya vibaya sana. Just see. Si mungewacha tu sasa iwe hata mara. I am at Mailine. This is Kericho County. Sindio
sinikiriko? Yes.
I am at Kericho County. This is Mailine. And on the 10th of December 2016, Honorable Uhuru Kenyatta launched this road. So there's a piece of the road that starts from Brook Bond to Mailine, and there's another one that starts from Chepseon to again to Mailine, to Kipkelion, from Kipkelion to Nondiani. This road was supposed to cost 1.6 billion Kenya shillings, and the road was done and completed. But when you look at the situation of the road, it is in a pathetic condition. In fact, it was very poor quality. Even the residents of this area are complaining. Ama mkonara. Actually, the residents of this area in 2021 walifanya maandamano. They were promised that the road will be attended to, but nothing was ever done. Kwa hivyo hii ni wizi wizi bila kazi. Now, we are saying this because people are saying, let people who have left power to go and rest and retire. Mheshimiwa Uhuru Kenyatta amemaliza kazi, wacha apumzike. I'm saying this, people who've left work and they stole from Kenyans, they should not rest. They should never rest and they should never retire until they return the money that was stolen from Kenyans. Paka saa hii wa Kenya wajui pesa ya laptops ya watoto ilienda wapi.
Yes.
Paka saa hii wa Kenya wajui pesa ya Eurobond ilienda wapi.
Yes.
Paka saa hii wa Kenya wajui pesa ya Aurora and Kimware ilienda wapi.
Yes.
Paka saa hii wa Kenya wajui pesa ya SGR ilienda wapi.
Yes.
Pesa imeibiwa Kenya left, right and center, and those people leave power, they go and retire and enjoy our money. Why? tuweze kuendelea. The other thing I'm telling you as Kenyans, hakuna ukabila. Ukabila tunauziwa na wanasiasa. Mimi nimekuja hapa na hata hawajaniuliza kabila yangu. Na hata hawana haja. Hata huyu mwenye ameniuzia hana haja. Wewe uko na haja?
Ni kina tu.
Hata hajauliza. Kwa hivyo hapa ni kwa Wakale. Lakini wenye wanaibia Wakale ni Wakale. Kwa hivyo hauwezi sema ati mtu wa kabila yako ni mzuri. Mwizi ni mwizi, hata kama anatoa kabila ingine ama kabila yako.
Mwizi ni mwizi.
Saa hii kuna vijana wengi sana hapa nimekutana nao. Wako na degrees, wako na diplomas, hawana kazi. Hiyo kazi yenye Ruto anasema amepewa watu 250,000 jobs. Sijapatana na hata mtu mmoja hapa amepewa hiyo kazi. Ama hayuko?
Hakuna.
Ama kama hako ainue mkono?
Hakuna.
Hakuna. Sasa hiyo kazi nani amepewa? Kama hawa hawana. Pesa ya CDF inaibiwa. Pesa ya county inaibiwa. MCA anaiba. Rais anaiba. Anaendelea kuuzia Adani Airport. Sasa Wakenya tutasaidika namna gani?
Rais aibi.
Itabidi sisi wenyewe tuamue tujikomboe. Tukatae pesa kwa ya wanasiasa ambayo wametuibia wanatuletea kwa campaign.
Yes.
Tuambie hiyo pesa ni pesa yetu. Kitu ya pili, tukatae ukabila.
Yes.
Kila mtu akuje na report card yake. Hata kama we ni wetu, bado ukuje na report card yako. Utuelezee chenye umefanya. Kama hakuna kitu, hawezi wote tunafagia kwenda nyumbani.
Wote!
Yes! Nikweli sikweli?
Nikweli!
Sijui kama tunaelewana.
Yeni mzuri!
Salali!
Yeni mzuri bwana!
Mimi nataka niwaeleze hivi watu wa Mailini.
Yeah.
Na nataka mnisikize vizuri.
Yeah.
Tayari. Hapa Mailini. Tumeweka mpango. Nikidanganya mnasema uongo, sawa? Tayari. Hapa Mailini tumeweka mpango. Semeni uongo.
Uongo.
Ya 15 billion.
Uongo.
Na hawa mama mboga.
Hakuna uongo.
Na hawa makanga.
Uongo.
Na hawa vinyozi.
Uongo.
Na wale wabeba beba.
Uongo.
Ili hawa wote waweze kukopa deni ya serikali bila interest. Sijui kama tunaelewana. Mimi nitazungumza na huyu mjumbe wenu. Kwa hii finance bill inakuja, nitaweka pesa ingine.
Uongo.
Ya uongo.
Na uongo. Hakuna uongo.
Tayari. Hapa Mailini, hapa vile vile. Tume connect stima watu 20,000. Katika mpango wetu wa last mile connectivity.
Uongo.
Hapa Kipkelion.
Hakuna uongo.
Tumejenga nyumba 15,000.
Kama
katika mpango wetu wa affordable housing.
Uongo.
Ni kweli si kweli?
Uongo.
Hapa Kericho County tumeweka barabara lami 1200 kilometers.
Uongo.
Hapa Kericho ni kweli si kweli?
Ni kweli.
Sijui kama tunaelewana.
Ni kweli.
Si mimi ndio nilikuja wakati wa campaign.
Yeah.
Si niliwaahidi.
Yeah.
Ahadi ni nini?
Ni deni.
Ahadi ni nini?
Ni deni.
Sasa mimi nitaweka mpango ingine.
Yeah.
Na mimi nataka niwaeleze hivi. Hatutaki fujo katika taifa letu. Tunataka siasa ya amani.
Ya amani.
Hatutaki maandamano. Mimi nitalipa hawa mabishop. Ili waombee Kenya yetu. Ili Kenya yetu iwe na amani. Ni kweli. Sawa watu wa Mailini. Barabara yenu nimeiona.
Lini?
Poleni kwa wizi ambayo imefanyika. Nitajaribu mahali naweza, sawa?
Ni Chinese.
Jaribu, jaribu,
jaribu.
Lakini hata nyinyi msikose kujaribu.
Hata kesho.
Si mnaona? Msikose kujaribu pia nyinyi. Hii kazi si ya Mkenya yeyote. Mimi silipwi kufanya hivi. Kwa hivyo hata nyinyi msingoje kulipo kubadilisha Kenya. Mjitolee kila mtu. Na si kazi ya vijana peke yake. Unajua wazee mmetuachia hii kazi.
Nasema ati
hao Gen Z ndio wako na nguvu, wacha wafanye. Hata wazee, you have the benefit of age and the benefit of experience. Make sure that you participate in changing Kenya. Sawa sawa?
Sawa sawa.
Bas. Wacha.
Bonga's number there. Kindly, guys, let's support him and the team to fuel gari yao tafadhali. The number is 0710452543, please. 0710452543. Tuma 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Itasaidia sana and it will be highly appreciated. You'll have contributed to building this nation because you're supporting the people who are going on the ground to inject and educate people on why we are against bad governance and how this government is oppressing us directly and indirectly. Your contribution will be highly, highly appreciated. Hiyo 10 bobu unaona ni kama ni kidogo, itasaidia sana. So please, usifeel ashamed, isiku hold back, just do it for your nation. Be a true patriot to support Mabonga. 0710452543, that's the number. Italeta jina Marvin Mabonga, aka KOT Sonko. Real Joe. Real Joe. Hey, hey, pick it up and please take the shortest time as possible. We want to hear everyone's voice and grassroots civic education. So take us through it.
Thank you, Toria. First of all, maybe allow me to answer a question that you had raised. I did not hear anybody answer it about the CS you were talking about the CS and the MP trying to set up laws, something like that. You asked such a question, right?
Okay, let me clarify it. It's not literally the MPs alone, because there are some senators bring on board some issues that citizens, okay, mwananchi wa kawaida cannot withstand. So we have the CS. What's the work of those CSs if these people go ahead and bring unbearable bills that we cannot withstand and they are just quiet?
Okay, thank you, Toria. First of all, you need to understand that our Constitution, Article 94, Clause 5, says that nobody other than Parliament has power to make provisions having force, the force of law. So only members of Parliament have been given that role to come up with laws as per our Constitution. So the CS can do nothing, and the CS and the Member of Parliament don't get in touch when it comes to legislation. But the same Article 94, the first clause, talks about the legislative authority, which is supposed to be derived from the people of Kenya. And therefore, any law that a member of parliament is supposed to come up with in parliament is supposed to derive from the people of Kenya. So just as you have raised the concern, yes, those legislations that they come up with, they don't derive from the people. And you've heard Mwangi, who is a farmer, talking about those bills that are being brought in parliament. They don't derive from the people. They don't even resonate with the farmers. So that is quite unfortunate thing that is happening in our country. So the problem is with the legislatures. They come up with the laws that don't derive from the people. I hope I've answered you, Toria.
Yeah, thank you. My question is quite answered.
Okay, so grassroots civic education is a very important thing. And actually, our constitution asks us in Article 3 that we need to defend this constitution. Actually, it asks us to respect, uphold, and defend this constitution. Part of doing this is grassroots civic education. What Kina KOT are currently doing is creating awareness about things that are happening in our country, which is very, very important. It is because I tell you what, when this constitution was being brought up, the politicians drove the agenda, and people never even cared to read, understand what this constitution has in place for us. How good is it? What does it have? Any shortcomings from this constitution, things like that. When the politicians said it is good, people voted for it. Yes. I'm not saying the constitution is bad, but it was not a concept that the people did not read. Not so many majority of Kenyans read to and understood the constitution and saw the importance of it. It was a narrative pushed by politicians. So that is why now over the past few months, we have become more enlightened. We are talking about these things every day. We are talking about the constitution every day. So this civic education in the grassroots is very important. And you see, most of the problems that we have as a country is lack of awareness from majority of Kenyans. You see, the biggest problem currently in our country, and everybody who talks in this space has tried to articulate this to the current legislature. That is the biggest problem. We are talking about Auditor General's report. If we cannot have an Auditor General just giving out reports, because Article 299 asks the Auditor General is supposed to give reports and submit to Parliament. Parliament is then supposed to take action. You see, some of the exposés that Morara has been giving, majority of them he gets from the Auditor General reports. That is so absurd. If we can have those in Auditor General's report and we are not seeing action being taken, Parliament is supposed to review, debate, and take action on those Auditor General on those reports. Misappropriations of funds in millions, but Parliament is doing nothing. So our biggest problem is the Parliament. This Parliament is supposed to derive from the people, just like I've said before, as per Article 94. And therefore, anything that directly affects the people, the Parliament is supposed to take action on that. And Parliament has been given a role, Article 95, to review conducts of everybody, president, deputy president, and all the state officers. So the Parliament is the weak link in our country, because we cannot have, and that's why most of the people right now are talking about young people taking up these roles, because that is the first place we go in. That is the first place we fix the Parliament. If we fix the Parliament, we solve more than 70% of our problems. That one I'll tell you for a fact. Because the current Parliament as they are, they know, and there's this narrative, I've heard this narrative several times, and I don't like it. The narrative of opposition, let us just stop that narrative completely. It is a political narrative that has been there, that has been peddled over the years. There's no such thing as opposition. In fact, when the constitution talks about these things like the minority and majority, Article 108, party leaders, majority and minority, it does not really mean that minority is opposition. By the way, if you look at the current after elections, this Parliament, if we went with the way elections were, we would have had a majority side that was not with the government. Because ideally, majority was supposed to be Azimio. Okay? We would have had that. But what happens? There's this other narrative that, let us join government. It's a fallacy. Parliament is government. It is an arm of government in itself. So there's that fallacy that we have joined government. They are in opposition. Those are political narratives. And that is what is affecting our country, because the president now goes and misuses the members of parliament. That's why we are seeing we cannot have oversight. That's why we are seeing things like Adani are just coming up, surfacing and all that. There's always the previous regime and this regime. I'm seeing primitive accumulation of wealth. And they are competing for that. Uru and Ruto are competing for accumulation of wealth. They will steal. They will loot from us if we are not careful. They will loot. The Parliament is not assisting the people of Kenya. It is not even deriving from the people of Kenya. That is a problem that we have. So to defend this constitution, we have to go to the grassroots and provide civic education. That is the part. That is our defense mechanism of this constitution as per Article 3. We go to the grassroots and provide as much civic education as is needed. And I like what Farah said, that in Akeoti, when they are going to the Rift Valley, they need to talk about things, agriculture and that. So when they go there, they need to resonate with the people, even them. You don't go there and tell them about things that are happening. You tell them about things that are happening on their where they are, things that they are familiar with. That's how we get to the people. So as I learned, the first solution we need to find a solution of fixing our parliament. We will solve most of our problems in this country. We will solve them, I'm sure. Anything to do with corruption, we'll solve. Misappropriation of funds, we'll solve. These draconian bills that we are seeing in parliament, we will solve if we get proper legislatures in parliament. Thank you very much, Chora, for the mark. I yield. Thank you.
Welcome, and I really support that. And I think as much as we're doing this grassroots civic education, we should also emphasize on a political world education, because people think the bills are the issues. Most of the bills are the issues, and the wool. As far as you're saying that the wool government is a problem, the parliament, I said in another space that the parliament is where our problem lies, because these bills, they are passed in the parliament, they are brought up in the same parliament. So how can we change this? We can change this by what? You and me standing vie for these seats, we replace them. We go there knowing that you're going there to speak the voice of the people, not what we want. The problem with these people is that they put their desires in front of the desires of people who sent them there to be represented. So thank you so much. We need a change, and change starts from us. That change is us, ourselves. So if you are capable of, if you feel like you can vie for any seats, Gen Z's, kindly, this is the time you should be on the ground trying to teach people on civic education, emphasizing on them why they should do this and not that, why they should choose this path and not that path. Make them understand why we want to liberate our country, why we want to drain this swamp once and for all. So thank you so much, Real Joe. I support you. Fundi, hi.